right, so let's work on chapter 4 for a few minutes. And I'm going to be in the part on page 82 where it says exercises. And I'm going to do the first, you know, kind of selected problems out of the easy part, 1 through 12. I'm going to start with number 2. And on number 2, we are given 3/1000ths of a gram. And we are asked to convert that into milligrams. And again, notice I'm not going to put an S on any of my abbreviations. I'm just going to use G for gram, MG for milligram. And I want to figure out, well, how would I convert grams to milligrams? And this is a metric system number. Grams is a weight, so I know I need to stay just with weight numbers. And if you're using your reference, your formula sheet, your grams will be under your metric system equivalents. And in that system, you want to look through to see if you have anything written with grams equal to milligrams. And so I'm going to look through and I notice that I have 1 gram equals 1,000 milligrams. So what I'll do is I'm going to write down what I'm going to use. And so that would be a good habit. 1 gram equals 1,000 milligrams. That's the conversion I'm going to use. This will just be a one-step problem, very quick and easy. Because this is the conversion I'm going to use, I can either write it as 1 gram over 1,000 milligrams, or I can put the 1,000 milligrams on top over 1 gram. So I'm going to have a choice. But any conversion you pick, that means it's going to be made into a unit fraction. Now, I happen to be converting 3/1000ths of a gram. So when I go to set up my problem, since I already know which number I'm converting, I'm going to take that and put it over 1. Then I'm going to multiply it by a unit fraction. And you just have to decide which unit fraction would you use. Well, would you use the first one or the second one?
Second.
And you'd use the second one. Why?
Because the grams are on top.
Because the grams are on top here, which means the grams have to be on the bottom here. So 1 gram, 1,000 milligrams. So this looks a lot like we were doing in Chapter 3. It's just now we're going to focus on metric apothecary household systems. Well, that means my grams will cancel out. Now, do you multiply by 1,000 or do you divide by 1,000?
Multiply.
Why? You multiply because it's on top, okay? So this is just like traditional multiplying fractions. It's on top, so you would type in 0.003 times 1,000, and you end up with what?
33.
Okay, and 3 milligrams. I heard someone say it, but you want to make sure you write it. I'll go ahead and tell you right now, worksheet or test or anything like that, you've got to have the units written. And if you don't have them written, I will take off a point. I think on the last time I only took off half a point, now I'm going to start taking off more. So make sure you put units with it. So 3/1000ths of a gram, the same thing as 3 milligrams. Okay? Number 4, we have liters and milliliters. And I have 3 liters. Now, liters is something you use on a regular basis. If you're ever buying soft drink, a lot of times you might buy a 2-liter bottle of soft drink. 3 liters in the milliliters, you might say, okay, that's another metric system, but this is a volume, and I want to convert the liters to milliliters. When you look in the metric system, do you see anything that converts milliliters and liters? Okay, you see 1 liter equals 1,000 milliliters. Now that's the one you're going to make into a unit fraction. And again, you would either do 1 liter over 1,000 milliliters or reverse. So it depends on which one you need. So I know which number to convert. convert, that's pretty easy because I'm just told 3 liters equals how many milliliters. Which one would I use, the first fraction or the second one?
The second.
Second fraction, so 1 liter. That way my liters will cancel out. And 1,000 milliliters. And just like number two, you're going to multiply 3 times 1,000. So we're looking at 3,000 milliliters. Okay? But the liters do cancel out. Okay, let's look at number six. For number six, you have 600 micrograms, so that's mcg, and you want to convert that into milligrams, mg. When you look through your metric numbers, is there a conversion with micrograms and milligrams? Okay, so 1 milligram equals 1,000 micrograms. And notice on your sheet you have one that says a little unusual looking U. That's a Greek symbol for micro. We won't use that symbol on a regular basis. We'll use MC in place of it. Okay, so you can really just disregard that middle part. That's an old symbol, but it can be confusing if it's not written properly. So 1 milligram equals 1,000 micrograms. And I already know it's going to make a unit fraction one way or the other, but I'm going to go ahead and start writing my dimensional analysis. Now, where would MCG have to go? It has to go on the bottom. So I look back at the conversion I want to use, and I have 1,000 micrograms, and I know it's equivalent to 1 milligram. So if you don't want to take the time to write the possible unit fractions, you don't have to. That's really not essential, but it's very good to know which conversion you want to use. And so micrograms will cancel. I'll have a milligram answer, which is what I want. Would you do 600 times 1,000 or 600 divide by 1,000? Divide. It's on the bottom. So that's just like before. It's what? 0.6? Okay. So 600 divided by 1,000. You're looking at 0.6 or 6/10 of a milligram. 6/10 of a milligram. Now, metric system, if you get a decimal, you want to leave a decimal. That's what you want. So make sure all your metric system answers don't have fractions. Make sure they have decimals. Metric system, you want decimals. Okay, number 10. Four tablespoons equals how many teaspoons? Now, this is a household number. If you do any kind of baking or cooking, you've probably run across teaspoons and tablespoons all the time. So look through the household section, and this would also be volume. What's your conversion that you would use here? Okay, I'm hearing it. One tablespoon is 3 teaspoons. Capital T is tablespoon, lowercase t is teaspoon. Please don't change it to TBL or TSP. We're only going to use the ones on the sheet. Okay? That's going to make my unit fraction. So 4 tablespoons over 1. I know that tablespoons will have to go on the bottom, so I'll take that conversion, put it on the bottom. And then what would go on top? 3 teaspoons. And 4 times 3, so you come up with the answer of 12. Now think about why we would, you know, find this interesting. Did you know that it takes 3 teaspoons to make a tablespoon? You know, you may or may not have known that. But if you were looking at a recipe, would you rather look at 4 tablespoons or would you rather look at 12 teaspoons? Can you imagine doing it 12 times and not losing count? that could become a little bit difficult, where you might accidentally put in 11 or 13. And depending on the recipe, that could make or break the taste. But for tablespoons, that's easier, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and then you don't miss that count up so much. So keep in mind where you, this is probably a preferred way to write it, but I do know that's equivalent to 12 teaspoons. All right, look at number 12. Now, number 12 is written as 32 ounces, and it's equal to so many pints. Because it's set equal to pints, is this a weight ounce or a volume ounce?
Volume.
It's volume, okay, because pint is volume. So make sure you don't confuse a weight ounce and a volume ounce. Okay? You don't want to get them mixed up. All right. The other thing I want you to realize is pints is listed on your sheet in the apothecary system, but technically it's also a household number. Okay? So you could have written it down beneath it with household as well. Ounce can either be apothecary or household. They're still the same ounce. It's just apothecary writes in a different way. So if you wanted to write the problem as this, that would be okay. I mean, it's not necessary, but it would be okay. So a lot of your apothecary numbers translate down to your household numbers. Okay? So if you're going, well, wait a minute, I don't see a number and then pint, use the apothecary version. Okay? That'll work just fine. Now, which conversion would you use? Do we have one that does ounces and pints? Okay, so on the apothecary way, it says pint 1 equals ounce 16. But it, you said, well, we didn't start with the unit first. We didn't start with apothecary. No big deal. This is the same thing. So what I'm trying to say is I will give you flexibility with ounces, pints, quarts. If you put the unit name first or second, I'm not going to be too picky. It's drams and minims that are the big ones in apothecary. I want to see that one written first. Okay? And we'll see those as we get to them. But either way, they're basically the same thing. So they're not a different ounce. So I'll start with 32 ounces over 1. And if I leave the ounce second instead of first, like I said, no big deal. What goes on the bottom? It goes what? Ounces, so it would be 16 ounces on the bottom and the 1 pint on the top. And you would do 32 divided by 16, and you come with what, 2?
2.
All right, 2 what? 2 pints. Okay. Now, we haven't run across one that gave us a decimal, but for example, let's say that we had 30 ounces, and we wanted to convert that to pints. You would still do 30 divided by 16. However, if you type that on your calculator, don't you get a decimal? Okay? Let's say you get confused. You're like, wait a second, I'm not supposed to give a decimal for household. I'm not supposed to give a decimal for apothecary. So what do? Think it like this. You can say 30 divided by 16. This will be pints. Could you not just write it like this and just reduce your fraction? Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you'd have 15 over 8. And you might say, well, that's a fraction, but let's make it a mixed number, which is even better. 8 will go in one time, and we have 7 left over, so I'm looking at 1 7/8 of a pint. 1 7/8. So if you have to turn it into a fraction, that's actually a better answer. 1 7/8 of a pint. But metric is decimal, household and apothecary are fractions. And if you have to, make them a mixed number, because that makes more sense to people. It's almost 2 full pints. Really, that's what I want to look at it and see. And then I'll say it's specifically 1 7/8.